In this tutorial, you will learn how to use PubMed to find articles that compare one drug to another, specifically learning about review articles and comparative studies. First, go to the library's homepage. You should always access PubMed from the library's homepage because it will ask you to log in. And once you do so, it will connect all of Boston University's holdings to PubMed, giving you one-click access to many full-text articles. Now that we're in PubMed, we're going to start our search. We're going to search for galantamine. And as you can see, PubMed gives you many different suggestions in this drop-down menu here. These are just suggestions. They are not the preferred terms. It's just search terms that people have searched for previously. So we're going to go ahead and stick with galantamine and click search. This brings us back just over 1,700 results. We know that most people start to panic if they have to go through more than 100 results, so 1,700 is definitely way over that panic threshold, and we want to narrow this down as much as possible. To do that, we're going to take advantage of a few features in PubMed, including filters and mesh terms. First, we're going to talk about filters. The filters are visible here on the left side of your screen underneath, here where it starts to say article types, text availability, publication dates. These are not all of the available filters because these are two-step filters. So first you have to show the filters and then you have to turn them on. So to show additional filters, you can click here where it says show additional filters. And these are all of the filters that are available to you. If there were other filters that you wanted, you would just check the boxes and click show, and then those filter categories would show. The filter type that we are most interested in is article types. And again, it just shows two types here, but we know there are many more different article types. So we're going to click Customize and ask it to show also comparative studies. Since we have not yet turned on any of these filters, your results numbers will not change. So you should still be seeing at this point 1,702 results like I am here. So we're going to go ahead and click on Comparative Study. And once we do that, our results are narrowed down to 217 items. We also know that ideally we would like our article to be both a comparative study and a review article, so we're going to click on review as well. This has increased our results to 527, so we know that rather than look for an article that is both a review and a comparative study, PubMed is actually looking for either a review or a comparative study. In order to have PubMed search for an article that is both a review and a comparative study, we are going to use mesh terms. Each of these filters here on the side is also a mesh term. So to gain a little bit more control over our search, we are going to use the terms from the mesh database rather than the filters. First, since these filters are sticky filters, meaning they will stay on until they turn off, we will go ahead and click Clear All to turn them off. Next, we're going to go ahead and change our database that we're searching from PubMed up here to Mesh. Type in comparative study. The first result is comparative study publication type. And this is what we're looking for. So go ahead and click in the checkbox here and then click Add to Search Builder. Next, we're going to search for review. Similar to before, the first one that we see is a publication type, and we can tell that it's what we're looking for because of the scope note that's available right here. So we're going to go ahead and click next to review and then click Add to Search Builder, making sure that it says and because we want something that is both a comparative study and a review. Now click Search PubMed. This shows all of the articles in PubMed. There are both comparative studies and reviews. But unfortunately, we still have to add galantamine into this because we're looking for comparative study and review that's also about galantamine. So we're going to click on Advanced Search here. And using this search builder down below, which is also our search history, we're going to click Add for galantamine and Add for comparative study and review publication types. And then go ahead and click Search. This brings us back 19 search results, which is well under the panic threshold of 100 results. While galantamine was recognized in these searches, PubMed doesn't always recognize drug names. I'm going to do a search for Viread, which is a relatively new anti-HIV drug. PubMed doesn't always recognize brand names, especially with new drugs, but it does recognize the chemical names, as you can see right here. So we'll still do a relatively good search. Sometimes it's better to search for the chemical name or the class of drug. So in this case, we will do a search for anti-HIV drugs and add Viread back into our search later. The best way to limit your search to a class of drug is to use MeSH terms. So we're going to go back into the MeSH database here and search for anti-HIV drugs. You'll see here that the preferred term is actually anti-HIV agents. We're going to go ahead and open up this MeSH term to take a look at it. Here you can see the scope note, which is what we used to identify our publication types in our previous search. You'll also see subheadings in case we wanted to narrow our search down a little bit more, as well as entry terms, which are all of the terms that PubMed is searching for when it searches for this particular MeSH term, anti-HIV agents. You'll also see below the MeSH tree. And the MeSH tree is particularly important because it is how all of the MeSH terms are categorized. You can use this tree to both broaden and narrow your search. To the right of anti-HIV agents are more specific terms, which will give you a smaller set of results, and to the left are broader terms, which will give you a larger set of results. Go ahead and click Add to Search Builder and search PubMed. Once back in PubMed, we want to edit our search so that we're including and Viread. And our search results number comes down to 484. Which is still kind of a lot to search. So we might want to add our filters that we used before, which were the article types for comparative study and review. However, as you recall from before, we were not able to just click these filter types here. Instead, we went into advanced search and we added the searches together, which is what we're going to do now. So I'm going to click on advanced search. I'm going to add our anti-HIV agents in Viread search, along with our comparative study and review publication types. And I'll click search. This brings our results down to 4, which is a very easy number for you to look through for your assignment. If you have any additional questions, please contact the reference desk at refquest@bu.edu or by phone at 617-638-4228. Thank you for watching this tutorial.